Hey, what's going on, guys? In this video, we're going to do a little show and tell with the Smith & Wesson Model 686 Plus Performance Center. Now, this is not mine. I don't own this revolver. This is a buddy of mine's who lent it to me for the video. So if you guys follow me, you know I've been doing these show and tell videos. And what that means is basically I'm borrowing a gun to show and tell. And the reason why I want to do a video about this specific revolver is because, you know, I've been getting quite a few private messages and emails from fellow YouTubers out there who basically, well, there's two things. They're like, hey, what happened to you, man? You don't talk about wheel guns. What, do you give up on the revolver? What happened to all the revolvers? Blah, blah, blah. So, you know, I do admit I've gone warp drive crazy with the 1911s, but that's because I carry a 1911 now. And to be honest with you guys, I've been thinking a lot more about the 1911. You know, a lot of people were saying, hey, you don't do any revolver videos anymore. And then I'm getting a lot of questions of people asking me, hey, if I want to carry a medium-sized snub-nose 357 Magnum, what would you recommend? So I want to show you this one here because I like the Smith & Wesson 686 series of snub-nose revolvers, you know, 357s. Now, this one right here is a Performance Center, and it's a 7-shot. And this one is a very nice revolver, and my buddy actually carried this one religiously for 2 years. Now, he does copy me because I carry the pug nose for a very long time, and he's not carrying this one either anymore, like me. What is he carrying? Take a guess if he's copying me. All right. Well, if you guessed the Wilson Combat, yeah, he's carrying a freaking Wilson Combat Commander-sized 1911. It's got a 4.25-inch barrel. I think it just came out. Actually, they just started building those maybe this year. Extremely nice 1911. But that's what he's carrying. And how is he carrying it? Take a guess. He's copying me. Inside the waistband, using a TT gun leather, Slim XC. Wow, commander size. So that's what he's carrying it now. So he's not carrying this revolver anymore. But he shot the hell out of this thing, man. The other night, he's like, hey, you want to borrow it for a video? I said, yeah, definitely. And he's like, well, let me clean it up for you. And I was like, no, don't clean that thing. But he did clean it. So the cylinder face was completely black, guys. It looked like a blued revolver from the front. Maybe you can see some of that carbon still. Yeah, you can. I mean, it was caked in. Like, I was just like, do you believe in cleaning your guns? He's like, no. So I'd be kind of curious to see how dirty he's going to get that Wilson Combat Commander. He did clean up, but it was like totally caked in carbon here. The muzzle was like, you couldn't even like see where the muzzle was. All right, maybe you can see it there, how it's crowned like that. Yeah, you can still see the carbon, but that was all blacked out. Inside the bore, it was not even shiny. It was like so dull looking. I was like, holy crap. But now he looks like he cleaned it up pretty good. Yeah, you can actually see some shine in there, in the bore. Where the forcing cone is, it was just... Actually, he did a pretty good job cleaning this thing up. Huh. Wow, he must have spent a lot of time cleaning this. But anyways, it's a very nice revolver. Like I said, it's coming out of the Performance Center. And it does have an unfluted cylinder, which I'm not a big fan of. I like a fluted cylinder because I like the way it looks, as well as if you had to reload this revolver using single round by single round, those flutes actually assist you with finding those charging holes. With a unfluted cylinder, you basically lost, you know, all your reference points here, and you gotta look down. But the reason for that is if you're gonna reload, you gotta keep your eyes up, head up, and you're looking for other threats while you're trying to reload, because one round by one round, if something happens, you can shut that thing up and go to work. But anyways, it also looks just like unfinished. The cylinder just looks unfinished to me. But some people really do like the unfluted cylinder look. But me personally, I could do without that. The trigger press on this revolver is phenomenal. Now, this has been a reworked trigger, meaning... Now, like I said, he shot so many rounds through this, like 3,000 rounds, mainly of 38 specials, but he's done plus P's, and he's put quite a bit of 357 Magnums. Now, he said he doesn't remember the round count, but it was way up there. The trigger started getting sluggish, and he had to send it back to Smith & Wesson. So he sent it back to Smith. He had it back within 3 weeks, and the trigger feels really good. So something happened inside here. I don't remember what he said exactly what it was. But they replaced something and did a whole overhaul on this revolver, and he claims that it shoots just like really well, like the trigger at least. It's just a very, very smooth trigger again, because he was saying it got really sluggish. Also, after that many rounds, he said the rear sight started to move, so I guess the screw backed out, so he had to readjust it. I got the red front ramp, which is something I like. I think it's pretty cool. You got a 2.5-inch barrel right there. So, if you're looking for a snub-nosed 357 Magnum that's going to be a primary carry, you know, a CCW, a medium-sized frame, this is an L frame, I would definitely look into this. Doesn't have to be a performance center. You can still get a standard 686, you know, whatever, pick your poison, 7-shot, 6-shot cylinder. But I would highly suggest a 686 if you're going to use it as a primary, you know, CCW, and you want a full stainless steel revolver. Now, Ruger does make some, you know, good revolvers, but I just don't have much experience with them. They have a GP series and an SP. I've known people that had the GP, I think it's the GP100, a blued one. I shot that. It was fine. You know, it was a good revolver. Those things are built like tanks. But I guess I'm a Smith fanboy, and I keep coming back to Smith & Wesson revolvers. Even though, guys, you know I've sent back my fair share of Smith revolvers, I still go back to them. I just like them, I guess, you know. So, personal preference, you know. I still really like the Smith & Wesson revolvers. Now, when he sent this one back to Smith, just like me and my pug nose, which I'm still waiting for that to come back, he had a backup revolver. Not a backup gun, but a backup primary. He has a 686, standard 686. So when this went back, he had the same 686, like same exact gun, just had one, you know, 6-shot. This is 7-shot, same dimensions, and he could use the same holster, the Milt Sparks VersaMax 2. He carried this inside the waistband. Now just remember, if you do really want to carry something like this, it's pretty hefty. Now if you're going to carry this inside the waistband, like my buddy, you know, that cylinder right there could prove to be a little challenging, because it's going to press up against your body, especially when you're wearing the holster, so it's going to be a little bit thicker than that. You know, that could just hit you the wrong way and kind of annoy you. Other than that, what is it, 34 ounces of weight? So it might be a challenge to carry this, but it can be done. It definitely can be done. With the pug nose, you know, that one has a much shorter barrel, lighter weight, shorter grips. I don't mind carrying that outside the waistband. I can conceal that. But inside the waistband with the pug nose, I never liked it. But I could do it. I would just have to deal with it. So this is just something to consider. So goes to show, it's a good reminder that if you have one primary gun, you should get another one, like of similar design or qualities, I guess. Just like me with my pug nose, if that goes down, I have another. I had another revolver to go to. Same thing with the 1911s. If our 1911s go down, we have another 1911 to take its place while it's getting repaired. So just something to think about. But yeah, this revolver served him very well. It's very attractive. It looks very nice looking. Got a little window there that exposes the extractor rod. You know, just a nice revolver. He kept the full-size grips, though. But I guess he's like, I don't have any problems concealing a full-size grip like that. But anyways, that's about it, guys. You can let me know what you think about this revolver. I think it's a nice revolver. If you're looking for a carry revolver, it's a medium-sized frame, like an L frame, 2.5-inch barrel, snub nose, I would definitely look into this or the standard 686. I'm not going to get into the ballistics and, you know, a ton of people. There was one time where I got, could have been over 100 freaking messages and so, oh, what do you think about using 357 Magnum? I have a snub nose. It's stupid. It's stupid. It's a waste. This and that. I don't get caught up in that, guys. Just get what you will. Get the round that you like. Load it up and be well. He loaded this thing up with 357 Bs. And that's a hot Magnum round. It's an old school Magnum round, but That's a really hot round, and some people will say, well, it's only got a 2.5-inch barrel. Why waste that, blah, blah. He didn't care. He still used it. He's like, I'm not using short barrel formula. That's his personal preference. You know, he doesn't get swayed by all the internet talk and, you know, videos from other channels saying this and that. He doesn't care. He's, I'm going to carry it, you know. It's going to serve him well. Me, personally, I'm the same way. I don't think it's a big deal. So, I guess that's about it, guys. You can let me know what you think about this revolver. I think, like I said, I like it. Would I buy one? No, because I have the pug nose. You know, I don't need something like this. If I didn't have the pug, maybe I would look at this. But the 686 is a really good revolver, I'd say. You know, so. All right, guys, that's about it. So leave some comments below. And as always, stay safe and check 360 often. Later.